Hi and welcome to Makeover Mondays, and in today's video I'm going to be going from this rather drab and boring bespectacled look to this more lush look here. Hello! Now, the eagle eye amongst you may have hopefully noticed that's my take of the wonderful Amanda Holden's latest look. So, Amanda, if you are watching, and I hope you really are, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell, whichever way around it is, if you want to get involved in the discussion. So, if you're not Amanda Holden, by the way, please hit those two buttons because we really do appreciate your support. So, without any further ado, if you want to see how I put it all together, please join me after the intro. Okay, let's slap this face in some sort of order. So off camera, I've hydrated this antique skin of mine. I've attached my facelift tapes in the usual places to above the eyebrows here, on the temples, and then along the jawline. So if you want to see how I do that, there is a link popping in above to a video I did on that fairly recently. So let's get things underway. I'm going to start by putting a bit of colour correction in, and the product I'm going to be using is the Dermocolour Body Camouflage in shade D32. And I'm going to put that in the areas around here. I don't know what you use, possibly if you use something different, just pop it down into the comments down below and share that with some of our people that are watching along. So let's get this underway. I'm going to be using a beauty sponge really to sort of pat it in a little bit and help it dry out. Next, I'm going to be using a little bit of concealer in the areas here, underneath the eyes, particularly along the bridge of the nose and along the forehead. This is quite a white base concealer. I'm just going to pat it in all the way over. Now, don't panic at this stage because it does look a little bit rough, or I do, anyway. It will all come together. Push this in quite close to the bottom of the eyelid as well. Keeping it in this V area here, right underneath the eye. Because this is the area that I want to be nice and bright and reflective. I'm just going to take a little bit up into the temples as well. This is quite a strong sort of white. Above the eyebrows themselves. And I'm going to take a fresh sponge, so I've got several of them, and start to push that in as well. You don't have to be precise, it's a bit random, but make sure that you've got a nice lighter area underneath the eyes, a little bit above on the forehead area down the centre of the nose. Once you're happy with that, the foundation I'm going to be using is from Crolon as well. It's the Vitacolor range, and this is a nice liquid full coverage foundation. I think they brought it in to replace a little bit of the Leichner range. I find it really good stuff to use. It's very, very buildable. And so the shade I'm using here is shade 4W. I'm just going to pop it on with a synthetic brush all the way over. Actually, I think I need a bigger brush than that, a big brush for a big area. So let's, as plasterers would say, let's whack it on there all over. And as with all foundations, it's used to even out your skin tone, so keep working it all the way in. If you don't have anything like this, you can use MAC BB cream is good too. Once again, I'm going to remove or turn to my beauty blenders, which will hopefully help to speed up the drying a little bit and even out the makeup a little bit better. Okay, so to reduce the last bit of shine off of this possible, I've got a cotton pad here. I'm just going to soak out all the remaining oil that's left on, Okay, I'm happy with that. And now let's put these facelift tapes into position and pull them into position. So I'm going to prepare the eyes using a soft ochre by MAC. Right to the bridge of the eye, corner of the nose, blend that in. Okay, so I'm going to start off by doing a bit of a cut crease. I'm going to be using a MAC mulch. I'm going to go right into the socket line because it's a nice brown colour. So I'm going to force that into the socket line, quite high up. I'm going to take quite a domed blending brush here because I want to push the brown right the way around the eye. So I'm going to get right into that socket line and I'm really going to work it all the way around. Take it right up to the socket bone itself. Don't be frightened to stretch it up high. Next colour I'm going to take is by MAC again. It's a carbon, so it's a very dark black. I'm going to go all the way over my eye, but before I do that, actually, to add a little bit more depth into my eye and make them pop a little bit more later on, I'm actually going to line the inside of my eye using this face liner by Crolon. I think the colour is 20. And I'm going to push this particular brown liner right the way into the roots of my lashes. I chose brown because it's a bit more forgiving than traditional black eyeliner. I'm going to leave the bottom of my eyes until a little bit later. I'm going to work this carbon black into my lid. Just going back in with the brown a little bit. Take the colour up a little bit higher. Go back in with the original brown face liner pencil I did the lash line with. The lashes I'm going to use are my usual DB20s from the Amazing Shine range. If you do have problems putting lashes on, there is a link going in above a video I did fairly recently on how to apply your lashes. Hopefully that might help a little bit. Squeeze it over a little bit, just pop it into place just to make sure it's all nice and secure. So I'm going to line my lips with MAC Coffee lip liner. I'm going to be using, what am I going to be using here? Whirl by MAC as my lipstick colour. I'm going to build up a couple of coats of it because it's quite dense. I need a nice full lip. So let's just start building that up. I'm going to be using the actual lipstick itself as a bit of a blusher as well along my cheek lines, just to emphasise them, because I want the colour to be quite sort of bold, but not too in your face. So I'm just going to be using a bit of the lipstick, taking it right along my cheekbone area. Two lots of highlighting powder. I'm going to use my usual MAC Mineralized Skin Finish Soft and Gentle, just for really punching out my forehead area here down the center of my nose, and the all important little area underneath your eyes, just to make them pop out a little bit more. Not too much, just enough to seal the area in. My cheek line. My cleft area. I change your brushes over and use a slightly darker one. This is again is a mineralized skin finish, but this one is gold deposit, to make them cheeks pop just a little bit. And that is basically it. All we require is the iconic hair that she's been wearing lately. So I'm just going to pop off screen. Be back in a second. So voila, there we go. A little bit of hair, which is a Taylor from the Noriko range in a shade, what is it, champagne rooted. If you want to find out a little bit more, there's a link down below. I hope you enjoyed that tutorial. If you want to find out a little bit more about the products and all the things I've used, again, they're in the links down below. If you want to see a little bit more of my Amanda impersonation, hang on a second. There's a little bit of a showreel to follow, but all remains for me to say is thank you very much for watching, stay gorgeous, and please, please, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. So stay well. Bye-bye.